I like that solar gives you the freedom to be anywhere. You're not tied into thinking about, can I plug into the grid here?
You don't have to pay a bill and you don't have to rely on anybody else.
I think we'd definitely be advocates for solar and renewable. It's kind of been our thing from the start, isn't it, to try and minimise that impact on the planet. Solar, I think, is the way to go.
I'm definitely an advocate for solar and renewable energy. It is part of the passive house process as well, and it relates to the levels that you can achieve. We're targeting premium, which is the highest level here, and that the main difference is around your renewable energy generation and consumption.
I'd say I am an advocate in general for solar energy. I think other forms of energy seem almost ridiculous by comparison.
I think absolutely yes. I mean, it's been perfect for the Glamp site. We've just loved it. And I think if we ever, we never plan to shift, but if you ever built a house, you know, we'd
go
absolutely
off the grid.
Look into that and probably go off grid, hey? Mm.
Fortress Stony Batter, where we are now, has been an abandoned place for the last 70 or 80 years. Part of the constraints on the site, as I've indicated, is no electricity. So sure, I could go and spend a vast amount of money and run cables to the main road, etc. But I really didn't see that as a solution. In approaching these constraints, it's about being clever in our solutions. Clearly, solar is the future. Photons have been falling on the Earth for thousands and thousands of years. We're only beginning to use them now.
Like, once you have your startup costs, then it's just, it's free.
The sun shines every day, and even when it's not shining 100%, it's still enough to do.
Still getting everything. Something through, yeah.
Everything you need. So definitely, highly recommend it. I think it's got to be the way we go, otherwise things aren't going to be so great for us.
Where are your power bills going? They're only going in one direction. That, you know, that's not going to change. And that's the good thing about this. You install this, I know how much this costs. I know how much my power bills are going to cost. I don't know how much it will cost in sort of 15 years, say, or 10 years to replace those batteries. But my guess is, what we've seen from battery technology is that it gets better. Therefore, the price of my batteries will get cheaper in 10 years. What's going to happen to your power bill? I don't know.
Who knows?
I very much doubt it's going to go down in 10 years. So I'm going with this. That's my bet.
One of the things that I was surprised about with solar was when you're living out in the sticks, you often have to spend a lot of money on your property anyway, so it's a long way from anywhere. I think that maybe people don't understand how affordable solar can be. Yes, there's an investment involved. It's actually really affordable. It's not massive compared to the rest of your property investment.
I particularly agree with that. Where you can contribute some DIY yourself,
that
obviously reduces labour or implementation expenses. But having implemented both the Weekend Warrior Kit and the Freedom Kit myself without any experience, just with the resources provided and support provided by GridFree, I can absolutely say anybody can do it. It's just not that hard. And if you need to get an electrician in to plug it into the mains or into a backup generator, that component doesn't have to be that expensive either, because it's a very small component of the actual build. At the moment, there's so little power consumption here anyway, and this little Weekend Warrior Kit, I mean, it's ideal. It gives us more than the power that Louisa will ever need for the stuff that she's doing. Computer, phone, coffee maker sometimes. She's talked about a small fridge, maybe a fan in summer.
I think that with the demands that are becoming more apparent on our electrical infrastructure around New Zealand, being able to generate some of your own electricity for your demand is becoming more and more important.